what happens if I add, in the addition of the vectors, what happens if I add the negative of a vector to the vector itself? So now you see, the negative of the vector is the same. It is a line parallel to itself, same length. Now you apply that head to tail principle. What will happen? It'll shift here, okay? From its tail, okay? I'm just drawing it a bit below it, okay? Because otherwise it'll totally cover it. So or maybe here, see? So it'll be just over this and in the opposite direction, is it not? So this was the initial point of the first vector, and this has become the end of the second vector. And we have been told to connect the initial point to the final point. So A, this is minus A, A minus A is what? It is 0. But it cannot be 0, it has to be O vector. It is designated as O, okay? It is O vector. It is O vector. Why? Because sum of two vectors or difference of two vectors, that can never be a scalar. Now you understand the significance of why zero vector was defined in the first place. You understand? Because these two vectors, they simply cannot yield a scalar. It's kind of, okay? It's kind of this, if I say I've given you two oranges, and I have taken back the two oranges, how many oranges do you have left? Then you will say zero oranges. You will not say zero lychees or zero mangoes. You don't say that. Okay? We are left with zero mangoes. Though technically you can say, if you have nothing, it can also be zero kingdom of Kuwait. Okay? So, but we don't say like that. Okay? When likes are being added or subtracted, they yield the likes, even if it is zero. I am left with zero toffees, no toffees. You say that? I gave you 10 rupees, I took the money back. So you are left with no money. You don't say I am left with no fruits. Okay? It does not go that way. Though if you have nothing, you can say I have zero, whatever. But we don't talk like that, right? So that is the idea of introducing a zero vector. So what happens, this zero vector, if it adds to a vector, it will not change the vector. You see that? If it adds to a vector, it will not change that vector. Okay? Fine? Now we come to a new topic called the scalar multiplication of vectors. So I do the scalar multiplication, of vectors. Scalar multiplication vectors. Okay. Scalar means what? A real number. One which has no direction. It has only the magnitude. So scalar is, scalar is any real number. Any real number. In this context. Okay. So I have a vector A. And I say I multiply it by 2. So what will happen the length of this vector will become the twice of what it was, the direction remaining the same. So if the scalar is positive,
the magnitude of the resulting vector gets multiplied by the scalar and the direction remains the same. Okay. Sorry. Now, what happens if I multiply it by minus 1? If I multiply it by minus 1, the vector immediately changes direction. So minus 1 into A, that is actually minus A. So what happens if the scalar gets multiplied by minus 1, the magnitude of the vector, the magnitude, if the vector gets multiplied by minus 1, the magnitude of the vector remains the same. And the direction gets reversed, and the direction gets reversed, and the direction gets reversed. We understand?
Yes.
Now I'll draw your attention towards the negative of the vector. There I had said that when I define the scalar of the vector, we'd like to come back. You understand? This is what it is. You actually multiply it by minus 1, which has the impact of keeping the magnitude the same and changing the
direction.
That's all. Okay. That's all it does. So, and if the vector gets multiplied by a negative number other than minus 1, then what happens? If the vector gets multiplied by a scalar, by a negative scalar, minus lambda, other than minus 1. Okay. Then what happens?
It will change the magnitude as well as direction.
The magnitude gets multiplied by mod minus delta, which is delta. Okay, and the direction gets reversed. It can be thought of as being multiplied by two scalars in succession. That is the best thing to understand. Okay. It can be thought of as multiplication by two scalars in succession. First, minus 1, which reverses direction, keeping the magnitude same. Then by lambda,
which changes the magnitude
depending on direction same. So if someone says minus half, I multiply a by minus half, what I do, I first reverse it like this, okay? So this is multiplication by minus 1 and then I multiply it by half. So its size becomes, so this is minus half a. So you first multiply it by minus 1, so it's the same vector, the head and tail change their respective positions and then you multiply it by half, okay? That's a better way of understanding it, okay? So that is scalar multiplication of a vector, scalar multiplication of a vector, okay? Now that you understand the scalar multiplication, I'd like you to come back to the concept of unit vector that I had again said that I'll bring you back when I'm discussing the scalar multiplication. What happens about a unit vector? A unit vector is a cap is a upon mod a. So that can be thought of as a getting multiplied by 1 by mod a. Now as per our scalar multiplication of vectors, what does it mean? It means that the length of this vector will get multiplied by 1 upon its own length. This is what it means. See, if I am saying 2a, it means whatever is the length of the original a, you multiply it by 2. Now here what I am saying, whatever is the length of this vector, you multiply it by 1 upon its own length. So if it is 5, 5 is the length, then you multiply it by 1 upon 5. So 1 upon 5 into 5 becomes 1. So that's why this will always give you a unit vector. You understand that? That's why it is a unity vector. At times people say that it is vector A divided by its own magnitude. Actually, that way, the scalar division we have not defined. Scalar division is nothing but multiplication by the reciprocal. So when you say A, vector A upon 2, when you say vector A upon 2, it is not as if vector A is divided by 2, it is as if it is multiplied by half. You get it? It's one and the same thing. So we did not take the bother of in fact division, as you have studied till now, 3 upon 4 is nothing but 3 multiplied by 1 by 4. Okay. That way division is nothing different from multiplication. Okay? So it is the same thing. So it is 1 upon length of vector. So magnitude, I am just talking about the magnitude right now. So magnitude becomes 1 upon the length of the vector into the length of the vector A. A. So that becomes 1. That's why it becomes a unit vector. Okay. That's why it becomes a unit vector. So you should again go back and see the definition of it, then you'll realize. Yeah. I had told you that when we come to scalar multiplication, I'll tell you something more about it. This is what.